Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Play Star Wars Rebellion. This game is a grand strategy kind of game. Kinda if you've ever played Crusader Kings or Europa Universalis, it's kinda similar to that, but not quite as complicated. But yeah, we'll get started here. We'll be playing with my friend Merrick from Brazil. And enjoy.
I am C-3PO Human-Cyborg Relations, and this is my counterpart, R2-D2. We have prepared a report on the current state of the galaxy. As you can see on the galactic information display, the galaxy is in a state of turmoil. Our recent destruction of the Death Star has drawn many core systems to the Alliance cause. However, as you can see, many systems still remain loyal to the Empire. Several of the core systems are controlled by the Empire because the planets are garrisoned by Imperial troops. Those systems would join us, but the presence of Imperial troops makes that difficult. There are many systems along the rim of the galaxy which are little known to us or to the Empire. These systems would make excellent bases for our forces. We currently have two bases in the galactic rim. One of these bases is on the fourth moon of the planet Yavin, which you can see indicated here. This is the base from which our fighters launched to destroy the Death Star. I should point out to you that the Empire now knows that we have a base on Yavin. R2 has calculated the odds that the Empire will attack Yavin shortly at almost 1-to-1. Perhaps we should evacuate that base. Our other base is here. This is the location of the Alliance headquarters. Alliance intelligence believes that the Empire does not know the location of our headquarters at this time. Fortunately, our headquarters can be transferred to another system if you feel that it is threatened. You should remember that the loss of our headquarters would be a terrible blow to the Alliance. I'm sure you recall the location of the Imperial capital here on Coruscant. This is the most significant system in the Empire. This is the location of Emperor Palpatine's palace. If we could take Coruscant, that would take us a long way toward defeating the Empire. Our fleet has been dispersed after the Battle of Yavin and is now outnumbered by the Imperial fleet. I suggest we begin a shipbuilding program to strengthen our fleet. There are also troops, fighters, and system defenses located with each of our bases, as well as some facilities located on the core systems which are loyal to us. The President of the Alliance, Mon Mothma, is located here with the Alliance headquarters. Intelligence indicates that the Empire has targeted her. The capture of the President would be a significant loss to the Alliance. Our sources also indicate that Imperial agents are searching for Luke Skywalker. We know that Master Luke's abilities with the Force will make him a prime target for the Empire.
Okay, so my briefing
Losing
just ended.
Master Luke would mean that our best chance for victory would be lost. I'm sure I don't need to remind you about Emperor Palpatine and his evil henchman Darth Vader.
Mine is
they
almost
are
there.
The leadership of the Empire. If they could be captured, it would be a severe blow to the Empire. That ends my briefing. I hope you enjoyed it. We are ready for your orders. And might I add, good luck, and may the Force be with you.
Alright folks, after that long briefing by 3PO, so starting out with Star Wars Rebellion, we have, well, we're playing the Rebellion, so obviously our first goal is to kind of expand from where we are. Merrick's playing the Empire, so he is sort of, has his own goals of expansion right now.
I have to take down the rebel scum.
So obviously on my end, one of the first things I want to do is kind of do a little bit of diplomacy, try and expand out from there. Whether or not that's a good thing, we'll find out. Sometimes it works.
I'm on my way.
Do you want to move the speed up towards the next level so we can at least have a little bit of agility here?
Oh yeah. So we'll be doing this at fast pace. Generally in Rebellion, you don't want to do this game at fast pace all the time, but against a human opponent, it's not too bad. When you're doing it against the computer, it gets a little crazy. They always send like a ton of sabotage missions and all that against you, and it's just a pain in the ass.
I have some characters that I did not have before.
Yeah, that's another thing about Rebellion, is that every playthrough you have your set of main characters, you know, Han, Luke, Chewie, and then you also have a random set of different minor characters.
Gotta deal with this rebel scum.
The fleet is ready, Admiral. What are your orders?
Blue group acknowledged. Engaging targets.
So this is the space combat portion of Rebellion. It's a nice little bit. Of course, in this instance, it's Star Destroyer against my one little Y-Wing squadron.
I don't think they're squadrons, I think they're just units, actually.
They are actually squadrons. If you select the group, it shows, like, in my instance, it shows Y-Wings 1, indicating one squadron, and then 12 by 12.
Oh, yeah. The same happens for the TIE fighters I have. Want to give them a brief overlook of the way things work?
So, obviously this isn't a very good example, but as you can see, I mean, for the time when Rebellion came out, this was a kind of pretty neat little thing. It when we actually start the combat, it actually simulates it pretty decently as far as the Y-Wings against the Star Destroyers and the fighters and all that. You have several different options, you know, between choosing different attack targets, different maneuvers to go about it doing those attacks. And it's an overall, it's a decent little setup for the combat map. In future battles, we'll do something a little bit more creative, but right now it's just a small little fighter against the Star Destroyer. So, Merrick, I'll let you start it up when you're ready.
Alright, there it goes.
This should be over.
I do think you can retreat, you know?
If I had more assets, I might probably consider retreat, but since this is just a single fighter squadron or whatever, I'm just gonna attack.
The resilience of the white wing is Necessity.
Reporting, they're taking losses. Our fleet has been destroyed. The Empire.
And that was over pretty quick. So as you can see, the Empire has blockaded Chandrila there. I imagine they're probably going to attack pretty soon.
There are units assigned to the mission which are not capable of acting on the assigned target. I'm afraid no mission could be formed. R2 has a message from one of our field personnel.
Oh, that's not good.
So, Merrick just tried to incite an uprising on one of my worlds, but it doesn't work very well. Now, obviously, when you go to incite an uprising, you do generally want to try targeting a system that has a bit more favor. So, which we might see in a moment, you know, whether or not I'm successful.
I'm afraid R2 has some bad news about support for the Alliance. R2 says one of our agents is reporting in. R2 has a message from one of our field personnel.
Understood.
So how long it's been since you played this game last, Nubis? I mean, actually played.
The last time that I actually did a full playthrough of this game, it's probably since college, so at least like 7 years almost.
That's a lot, huh? I think I was a kid when I played this game. I don't think I ever got all the way to the end, to be honest.
In my long time playing this game, I've beat it a couple times here and there.
There is a message from the president.
the Emperor is failing in his mission and he's blaming it on me.
Gotta love that.
Our goal has been achieved.
Yeah, obviously, when playing this game, one of the big things is to use your hero characters like Mon Mothma, Palpatine, even some of the more notable Rebel characters like Luke or Han to do recruitment missions.
Understood.
R2 says one of our agents is reporting in. I'm afraid R2 has some bad news about support for the Alliance. There is a message from Captain Solo. R2 indicates that a manufacturing message has been received.
That didn't go very well.
We've got to do better.
R2 says one of our agents is reporting in. R2 has some good news about support for the Alliance. There is a message from the President. There is a message from Princess Leia. There is a message from Master Luke.
We did it!
R2 says one of our agents is reporting in.
So many mission reports.
There is a message from Princess Leia.
Same here, actually. It's because the speed is up.
Yeah.
I'm afraid R2 has some bad news about support.
All these things to do.
And you're doing really good with your diplomacy right now.
So I am.
There is a message from Captain Solo. R2 says one of our agents is reporting in.
You got it.
There is a message from Princess Leia. There is a message from Princess Leia.
Sometimes
oh my god, all of these message reports.
Haha, take that.
Oh shit!
Good news about
I waited too long.
R2 says one of our agents is reporting in.
No more Star Destroyer over Chandrilla.
There is a message from Master Luke.
Our mission was successful.
R2 has some
wow,
good news
it takes
about
like a whole
for the Alliance.
Year to make these.
R2 indicates that a manual.
Yeah, especially with only one shipyard.
There is a message from Princess Leia.
It's okay, I'm handling that.
There is a message from one of our fleets indicating it has dropped out of hyperspace and has arrived at its destination. There is a message from Master Luke.
Our mission was successful.
There is a message from Princess Leia. There is a message from Master Luke. R2 has some good news about support for the Alliance.
I hope you know what you're doing.
Ah, you got some really good agents reporting in.
Right away.
R2 says one of our agents is reporting in. R2 has some good news about support for the Alliance. there is a message from one of our fleets indicating it has dropped out of hyperspace and has arrived at its destination. There is a message from Master Luke. R2 has some good news about support for the Alliance. There is a message from Princess Leia. R2 says one of our agents is reporting in. Yes.
All right, folks. Now, as far as you can see, our credits are shown up here. The little, by the little wrench. And it's determined between the mines, which are located here on that galaxy overview, and the refineries. So your general goal is to have them be pretty much equal and then raise them gradually. As you can see, I have way too many refineries right now, which kind of shows that I can destroy a few to make room for other facilities and that sort of thing.
Rebellion is spreading.
Yep. So, also another thing that you can do, especially in these games with the huge galaxy, and especially at the rate that it's going, you can click on your advisor, in this case it's 3PO, and have him manage, like, garrisons.
You want me to supervise our planetary garrisons?
That way, he'll use free troop facilities to pretty much send troops throughout, you know, the galaxy and all that to sort of garrison worlds that the Rebellion owns.
I will admit I did not know that.
You never knew that you could have your advisor manage your garrisons and that sort of thing?
I did not.
Yeah, you just right-click on him and he'll take over doing that. They sort of focus on,
I'm on my way.
Like, if there's a world that has, like, a large garrison requirement or whatever, then they'll send more to that world first. They can also manage production to raise your credit amount and that sort of thing, but as it is right now, we're doing pretty good on that, so I don't really need to do that.
You got it. Right away.
How can I assist you?
Also, folks, say you're doing a bunch of diplomacy missions in this game. You can also go down to this little button down in the corner of the Galactic Information Display. Click on it and go to Personnel and look at Idle Personnel. That'll show you where you might have people who aren't doing anything. You can put them to work, have them go back to doing more diplomacy missions, that sort of thing.
Poor Pter Thomas, killed in action.
Wait, killed in action?
Well, no, it just says killed, but he wasn't doing that. He was doing that mission right at the beginning.
I don't remember killing him, but I guess he died.
He was trying to incite a rebellion, a revolt.
Aha, poor guy.
RIP.
You got it. I told you it was gonna work.
Oh wow, I got Befell Leminski.
We need to keep this up.
What is he even doing there? Inside a Star Destroyer, just sitting around doing nothing. wasn't he the designer of the Death Star or something?
Bevel Lemelisk?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or, well, he's like one of the designers. At least in the old expanded universe.
That was a mess. Understood. Understood.
Now, another feature of this game that I forgot to mention is when going around as the Rebellion, especially in the Outer Rim, there's a lot of planets that don't have any populations on them. So as you can see on this one, I've just pretty much drag and drop a troop regiment onto the world. Now for the moment, it still doesn't have a population, so if I were to pull that regiment off of the planet, I'd lose control of it, and it'd go back to being neutral. But as soon as I actually set up some kind of civilian facility, like a construction yard, refinery, mine, that sort of thing, it'll fall into having a civilian population that will be 100% in support of the Rebellion.
Right away.
Haha. So, as you can see here, I successfully captured Clev in one of my daring attacks. That was sort of aimed at the fact that because he was doing ship design research, he was sort of a prime target for that.
Hope you know what you're doing.
Sometimes I amaze even myself.
Our mission was successful. That didn't go very well.
You would think Darth Vader would be very good at these diplomatic missions, but apparently this Imperial officer is way better than he.
Sometimes it varies with Vader. Sometimes he's alright, sometimes he's not.
You got it.
We did it!
It's not my fault. Okay, now what?
Understood.
How am I to know the good side from the bad?
You will know. A Jedi uses the Force for knowledge and defense, never for attack.
The targeting thing sometimes is a little sketchy.
What's a little sketchy?
When you're trying to target a planet to like a mission or something, sometimes it goes go.
Okay, now what?
And there's Merrick again with all his Star Destroyers.
Empire is bombarding one of our planets.
Am I getting away now? Help them. Oh.
Oops. Oh. And,
okay. Didn't even need anything that time.
So it looks like in bombarding Chandrila, based on the popular support, the world kind of just went neutral.
That works for me. So much for Mon Mothma's world.
Understood.
Uh-oh. Now he's moving along.
The fleet is ready, Admiral. What are your orders?
So seeing as he definitely outdoes me this time, I think the best thing is just to run. So in this case, it's just going to game options, go to this little button up here, withdraw from battle, and yes.
All units reporting in. The fleet is preparing to make the jump into hyperspace.
Flee before the might of the Empire.
The fleet is jumping into hyperspace. The withdrawal is complete.
And undoubtedly, we are about to lose Yuvina as well.
The Empire is bombarding one of our planets. You yep. must help them.
There wasn't any terrible laser defenses on that one.
Yeah, those two worlds, I didn't bother to really boost up any.
Bested us. Understood.
I am growing stronger with the Force. You got it. Thank you.
It's a really shame that aren't more games like this being made.
Yeah, it is kind of sad. I mean, as I said in my intro, that I recorded before starting this part, this game is kind of like, you know, Crusader Kings and EU4 and that sort of thing, but beyond that, and even then, it's still not exactly like that, though. Because, I mean, even though this game is complicated, it's not too complex.
Yeah, I would not say it's complex, especially when you have that whole garrison troops bottom for the advisor. I really did not know that one.
Yeah, there's definitely things that help out. The garrison troops thing is definitely one of the big ones. Because, yeah, especially given, you know, how many worlds, especially in a huge galaxy, definitely helps out.
I'm on my way. Didn't go very well. I'm on my way.
Now, another mechanic about this game, too, that I'm sort of showing on this end is, there are Force-sensitive characters like Luke Skywalker. And with Luke, every time he, like, fails a mission, even though he might fail the mission and it might be foiled, he'll experience what's called Force growth.
I am growing strong.
Which ultimately means that his abilities get stronger. As you can see on this screen, his combat rating is 163 right now, so he's definitely pretty capable.
I am growing stronger with the Force.
Skywalker will join or die.
I'm on my way. I am growing stronger with the Force. I've arrived.
Understood.
Really need to start using the minimizing feature of this game for the UI.
Yeah, I've been using it a little bit. As Merrick was talking about here, as you can see on the far side of the screen, I have several different areas set up for the important worlds, pretty much to keep track of, like, you can keep track of a fleet, you can keep track of the ground units, or you can keep track of the manufacturing facilities. Pretty much definitely makes things easier, especially when you get to the, you know, when you have to manage multiple sectors and that sort of thing. Uh-oh, he's expanding again.
Oh, all the fleets went. Okay.
One of our planets. You must help them. Oh my! Imperial troops are assaulting one of our planets.
Well, yeah, so that world's gone.
Oops. I put fears inside a carrier. That's not where he's supposed to go.
I think so long as they're in the fleet that they still contribute to it.
Understood.
How can I assist you?
Understood.
Thank you.
So, I've attempted to set a little, well, we'll find out. As you can see, Merrick has blockaded Sarka now with his massive fleet of Star Destroyers.
If there's one thing I know about this game, is how to build.
That appears to be true.
That's about all I can know how to do.
I am growing stronger with the Force. Right away.
Send the probe droid to Hoth. We'll see how that goes. I feel like someone is idle and they shouldn't be. Vader, why are you doing idle like that? Prove that you are more than a henchman. Go do something useful. Ship design. Fancy.
Yeah, that is one thing. The Empire does get some really nice ships in this game.
Stronger with the Force.
Uh-oh. He didn't fall for my trap. So as you folks can see, Sarka is pretty well defended with its gen cores and turbo lasers and troops and that sort of thing. So the idea was that he'd bombard Sarka and in doing so damage his fleet. But he decided he was going to be a bit little, go around to Amwat over there and destroy everything that was there. I was just hoping you wouldn't notice that I had those turbo lasers there.
After losing that entire Imperial Star Destroyer to a sabotage mission I've decided to keep a closer eye to my fleet.
Yeah, Han and Chewie did blow up that Star Destroyer.
Goddamn Corellian. Gonna go talk to him about the odds. Gonna have to have a conversation about the odds. I still have all rebel leader characters listed as on Yavin. Guess we had no intel on those guys.
I guess not.
Right away.
Bounty hunters located solo. I probably should have mentioned that, but...
Uh-oh.
These guys just don't know when to quit.
Oh yeah, and now I see that I got that message to Han Solo attacked by bounty hunters.
That guy who has totally not done anything ever since the beginning of the game. Now I'm having to micromanage ship.
That's the one thing about this game. It does get to a little point that you do have to micromanage a little bit. But, at least with a human opponent, it's kind of... It's not like, oh no, Chewie was injured.
I'm on my way.
Uh-oh. Well, given that I only have a few... Oh, jeez, look at all those ships. Yeah, given that I only have a few fighters here, I'm just gonna let the, I'm just gonna simulate the results for this one. Obviously, I was destroyed completely there.
Oh, yeah, I did lose two TIE fighters. Wow, and then the Imperial Star Destroyer was damaged.
Somehow those were pretty good X-Wings, I guess.
God damn it, Wedge! Curious.
Understood.
We showed them.
Understood.
Our mission was successful. We did it! We did it!
Understood.
Yeah.
Understood.
Oh, new. Sometimes the little droid, the Imperial Astromech, goes kind of crazy there.
He does have little moments.
Vader, what are you doing over there? Slacking off, that's what you're doing.
You got it.
Understood.
Hello again.
Hello again. You're trying all manner of sabotage missions.
How can I assist?
Yes, I am. Evidently, they're not working.
Yeah, that's what happens when you have a general there. Makes it much harder. Especially when you're just using the generic, like, Imperial Commandos or whatever.
Yeah.
I'm surprised that I've seen like half of the galaxy and I still have not seen any rebel worlds out there.
Oh, you mean the Outer Rim?
Yep.
Huh, I wonder where they could be.
Indeed. Oh, excellent. Apparently they died in the process, but okay. Either that or they're consumed.
Oh, your sabotage mission?
Yeah. But with one negative news, what? Your uprising, where are you? Oh, okay, of course, the place I just took. Of course they're near uprising. Why wouldn't they be? Oh my, TIE Defenders.
Ooh.
These guys just don't know when to quit.
You know, in spite of how cool TIE Defenders were, you know, how powerful and all that, I still, in the end, preferred the TIE Interceptor.
Really?
Yeah, it is my all-time favorite of the TIE series. There's, like, no discussion with me. It's like, okay, I understand that the TIE Defender was superior in every way, but for me, there's just something about the TIE Interceptor's design that's like appealing.
Of Imperial fighters, I've found, I think I like the missile boat the best.
Oh yeah, I've played those on those simulator games, the X-Wing series and all that.
The Empire is bombarding one of our planets. You must help them.
Uh-oh.
Well, that obviously worked.
Oh my! Imperial troops are assaulting one of our planets!
Except with your one little fleet regiment, you're in an uprising now, but...
Yeah, apparently I had only one fleet regiment in that place. I thought I had more. All right, this is the fleet that came out of that place. Okay. I understand now where that happened, where that went wrong. I see the error in my way. What?
Chewie! No!
What? Okay. Was he like en route to that location or something?
He was trying to blow up your one little garrison you had. Because if he did that, we would have gotten you off the world.
Yeah, except that there are a lot of worse people on the way.
Yeah.
Poor Chewie. I'm surprised they still don't have, I still do not have a advanced shipyard.
Really? I've had it for a while.
I don't know why, but I don't have an advanced shipyard.
Have you been doing, facility research?
Nope. I don't think I have any for facility research.
If you have Bevel Lemelisk, I know he does it, because he does everything, but...
Oh, right. Well, I have him on ship research.
Yeah, it's generally more important.
Understood.
Poor Vader can't recruit anyone. Yes, uprising has ended. May we have peace in our time. That is a bad thing to say. Oh, Vader actually recruited someone.
What do you know? He's useful.
Tell me about it. I don't really know this character, but okay.
Understood.
Mara Jade is not in this game, right?
No, unfortunately she's not. I mean, there's mods to add, like, various characters to the game, but yeah, base game, no, she's not.
Unfortunate. She's just a character that, well, it's very interesting.
Yeah, why they included Thrawn but not Mara, I don't know, but then
yeah,
again...
like, you have Thrawn who's off that era, and but not Mara. It's like, what?
I don't know if maybe it's just because Mara wasn't as popular at the time, maybe? I don't know. But then again, she was included in, like, Masters of Terras, Kas, whatever you call it.
Yeah, that fighting game for... it was on PlayStation, right?
Yeah, PlayStation.
Yeah, I played that game. Been achieved.
Understood.
Well, Vader is like outdoing himself now. Just recruited Dala.
Oh yeah, I forgot Dala's in this game too.
He's redeeming himself before the eyes of the Emperor. That was my evil laugh.
That was horrible.
Oh well. I'm not like, I don't know, 100 years old and decrepit by the dark side, so give me a break here.
Poor Palpy.
Oh, Advanced Shipyard has finally been developed.
Yay!
Kyle Katarr must be very pissed off right now. Dark troopers everywhere.
I will say dark troopers are pretty awesome in this game. I mean, they do pretty much everything. Oh yeah, while I'm thinking about it, since we're pretty far ahead, let's save it now, just to save it.
That is a good plan.
Saved successfully, yay.
Let's hope it loads too.
Well, theoretically it should. Theoretically.
Planets are starting to get be rather far from my probe droids. Guess it's time to move them. Alright, General Willard, you're like too old to me, so let's try this again.
Yes, let's try that.
Oh, I see that.
Yeah, this game always does show that now, doesn't it? Oh.
Understood.
Now this is where it's going to get interesting.
The fleet is ready, Admiral. What are your orders?
Now, this is the first real battle here.
Green Group acknowledges mission assignment. Blue Group acknowledges mission assignment. Red Group acknowledges mission assignment. Gold Group acknowledged. Engaging targets. Task Force 1 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 2 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 3 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 3 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 4 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 5 acknowledges mission assignment.
Oh wow, there's this four lone Galeon unit. Like, he's so fucked. Now, I do recall that there's a way to use the interdictor here, but I really don't remember how.
The interdictor is used automatically.
Oh.
It's not like Empire at War where you have to activate it or whatever.
Oh. Well, I'm ready.
I have unpaused it, so just gotta unpause it on your end, and I'm ready. Yep.
This is gonna be intense.
Absolutely.
The downside of my fighters is that they have to deploy. They don't start. Oh, that's the benefit of TIE Defenders. I think they come out of hyperspace and are deployed.
Yeah, because TIE Defenders have hyperspeed, so they can come out like that.
Red Group reporting. Target destroyed. Gold Group reporting. They're taking losses. Red Group reporting. Target destroyed. Green Group reporting. Target destroyed. Blue Group reporting. They're taking losses. Green Group reporting. Target destroyed. Gold Group reporting. They're taking losses. Green Group reporting. Target destroyed. Red Group reporting.
So much stuff going on that I don't know what's going on.
Ship reporting. Target destroyed.
Just trusting the AI here.
Yeah, I'm doing a mix of just having the AI do their basic stuff and then a few direct targets. Do you know how to directly target something?
Yeah, taking the click on the unit and going for the...
Yeah, right clicking and all that.
Oh, there goes my bomb.
Blue Group reporting, they're taking losses. Green Group reporting, target destroyed. Gold Group acknowledged, engaging targets. Task Force 4 reporting, they lost a ship. Red Group reporting, target destroyed. Green Group reporting, they're taking losses. Blue Group reporting, they're taking losses. Red Group reporting, they're taking losses. Red Group reporting, target destroyed. Gold Group reporting, they're taking losses. Gold Group reporting, they're taking losses. Green Group reporting, target destroyed. Red Group reporting, they're taking losses. Ship reporting, target destroyed. Gold Group reporting, they're taking losses. Green Group reporting, target destroyed. Green Group reporting, target destroyed. Gold Group reporting, they're taking losses. Green Group reporting, target destroyed. Red Group reporting, target destroyed. Task Force 1 reporting, target destroyed.
I am thoroughly disappointed in my Lancer frigates.
Against fighters, they are pretty good.
Yeah, I guess you just had way more fighters than I did.
I had 45 squadrons total.
Yeah, that's a lot. I don't think I had that much. I think I had 20 at the most.
Do you even have any fighters left?
Nope.
Reporting, they're taking losses.
Maybe they didn't bring enough, then let's forget some this one. Red group reporting, they're taking losses. Task Force 3 reporting, they lost the ship.
Green group reporting, they're taking losses.
Oh, they aren't doing their job, at least. The fires won't be long, last long.
Yeah, my fighters are almost destroyed now. I think there's one squadron left. So many disabled ships.
Yeah, he did a pretty good job at disabling them. Kinda just let the AI do its job, and obviously it didn't work very well.
Yeah, I did a mix between AI, and then I had my one group of B-Wings all go out and attack one of your Star Destroyers start out. Well, three ships have escaped.
Actually, I have plenty of the smaller ships.
Oh yeah, your Lancer frigates. So let's see, a Galleon, Escort Carrier, Lata-Lancer frigates.
God, and so many destroyed. A few ships, a few of the Victory destroyers managed to get away. All of the Lancer frigates managed to get away. Oh, I actually had like, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 Lancer frigates there. They did the job.
Yeah, you did take out all my fighters.
Yeah, there was one thing that worked. But yes, it was a pretty intense battle. God damn rebels. Rebels come.
Understood.
Oh, a recruited Pleon, or however you pronounce his name.
Pelion? At least that's how Pelion, I pronounce it.
Yeah, Pelion, I guess. Pelion? I don't know.
I've arrived.
Ooh, I just discovered 5 future Jedi with Luke.
5 future Jedi? I didn't know that existed. I
have found a new Jedi candidate. Luke goes to Dagobah and all that, and comes back. He discovers Jedi.
I
have found a new Jedi candidate.
So this game even has that. It shows how little of this game that I've played in the past.
Right away. And then you can take the Jedi and Jedi training missions and all that sort of stuff.
Oh, wow. A natural disaster and one of my planets just completely trashed the the infrastructure.
Yeah, I hate those natural disasters.
Oh, it was a very important planet.
Ooh, really? Ugh.
That is so sad. And one, and there was a natural disaster on Solus way long ago. It also trashed the infrastructure.
Yeah, that's one of the things I don't like about the game, because not only does it just, like, destroy your buildings and that, but it completely, like, takes away from the even the points to build further.
I'm here.
I got a future Jedi message, but I think it was on one of your planets.
One of the ones that you conquered, maybe? Oh.
Oh, it's like, it's a planet that I don't recognize, so I'm guessing it's yours.
If you look at the message on the right, there's a little thing that looks like a targeting display, and it says display. You can click that and it'll show the planet. Or the person or whatever.
Oh, I've detected that Griff has the ability to use the Force. Doesn't seem to select to be to allow me to do the mission.
Wait, what
maybe
mission?
It's supposed to be Emperor. Maybe it's supposed to be the Emperor that does the training.
I know you have to select both characters, and you have to select on a friendly planet. I can't do it yet. I can't do it yet with Luke because he's still a Jedi student. But I think when he gets to Jedi Knights is when he can do it.
Oh, I had no idea about that.
That didn't go very well. That didn't go very well.
You got it.
Oh, it wasn't a... I thought it was a planet. It's a character that could use the Force. I thought the character, the planet... It was a planet named Brandei, but it's a character named Brandei. I was like, what?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that is a character.
Wow. Well, Vader apparently sends him halfway across the galaxy, because that guy is way over there.
That's... interesting. Oh.
We did it!
I just keep capturing more of your people.
What? Oh. Huh.
Understood.
This may not go well.
It will be curious,
ready,
I guess.
Admiral, what are your orders? Task Force 5 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 4 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 4 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 3 acknowledges mission assignment. Task Force 1 acknowledged. Engaging targets. Task Force 2 acknowledged. Engaging targets. Task Force 2 acknowledged. Engaging targets. Red Group acknowledges mission assignment. Green Group acknowledges mission assignment. Gold Group acknowledged. Engaging targets.
That intense tactical maneuvering there.
Wait, you're fleeing?
Yes, I'm not sure if you noticed, but I have no fighters, and I don't intend to sacrifice my units like that.
Uh-huh.
Gotta be smart about it.
Drat, I couldn't save Chewie.
That whole battle just for Chewie.
I did have you targeted with the Star Destroyer that had him and all that, but okay, so we can end it here and then continue on maybe tomorrow or something.
Yes, tomorrow will be fine.